Is old school investigative journalism dead? Well, if you just pay attention to the mainstream cable news networks, you'd probably assume, yeah, it's long gone at this point. But there's more to journalism than just those faces on your TV. There's newspapers, magazines, websites, and things like that. We've actually got some data coming from researchers at Indiana University. They've put out this survey called The American Journalist in the Digital Age. And really importantly for us to evaluate the current state of journalism is to compare and contrast it with 10 years ago, 20 years ago, maybe even more. And so they've done this survey with over 1,000 US journalists, and they've done it over a long period of time. And so let's see what the people actually on the inside think about the state of journalism today. So first, what do journalists think is still ethical when it comes to gathering information and breaking news stories? Take a look at this. So there you're seeing controversial reporting practices, and importantly, the three bars you see for each category spans from 1992 to 2002 to just last year. And whether we're talking about that using hidden microphones or cameras, getting employed to gain inside information about perhaps a government department or a business, claiming to be somebody other than who you actually are, or paying people to divulge confidential information, you see that in every case in 2013, far fewer journalists think that it's ethical to use those means. Let's look at some more. Here you're seeing more controversial reporting practices. Again, we've got using confidential business or government documents without prior authorization from the government, which seems like the definition of journalism to me. Using personal documents such as letters and photographs without the owner's permission, and badgering unwilling informants, which is how every journalist in House of Cards seems to get their job done day to day. Again, in all of those cases, the most recent polling shows that far fewer journalists think that it's legitimate or ethical to use those means. And here's the problem with those results. You have to use those means. Now, yes, of course, in a couple of cases, you've still got majority support thinking that it's ethical, like using the confidential business or government documents. That's something, I guess we should be happy about that. But they're not willing to badger unwilling participants. They're not willing to lie about who they are to find out this information. Look, lying about anything is unethical in some way, I suppose. And yet we're talking about incredibly important, sensitive government activities that the average US citizen deserves to know more about. Moving on through the survey, in terms of like being able to choose your own stories, feeling autonomous in your job as a journalist, look at this. You're seeing that in 1971 into the 80s, the percentage of journalists saying that they had almost complete freedom in selecting their stories is still 60%. Unfortunately, beginning in the 90s, that dips down below half. And most recently in 2013, you're seeing that only one out of three journalists actually believes that they have the autonomy to choose and pursue whatever story they want. And I'm not surprised by that at all. I mean, if you're selecting stories based on what you're interested in or what you think is going to be most juicy, but it requires a lot of research, that takes time, and time is money when it comes to journalism. It's much easier to try to get them to shit out a couple of articles every day about whatever it is that the White House says they can talk about, whatever talking points have been handed to them by Republican senators, Democratic congressmen, whoever it is. Take their press release, turn that into news, and you've produced content for the day. And so this job autonomy thing has a very real consequence on the sort of journalism we get. Just sort of an interesting side note, the average age of journalists, look at this chart. Here you're seeing 1971, 37. It actually dips down to 32 in the 80s. That's relatively young. You're a few years out of college and everything. But look at the number rise up into 2002 and 2013. I don't know exactly what that says. Perhaps the young people, you know, who would have become journalists in earlier years are becoming bloggers or something like that now. And actually, you would expect that considering they're a little bit on the older side, they have been around in the business for a while, they would know what the American public expects from journalists, what the country expects from its press. But unfortunately, that doesn't seem to be working out. Another small note, the percentage of minority journalists in the 90s and into 2002 was actually going up pretty significantly. I mean, we're talking more than doubling from 1982 to 1992. Now, the number has slipped a little bit going into 2013. Again, we don't know exactly why that is. It could, again, be the influence of the internet or something like that. But in terms of representing an increasingly diverse America, we would expect that journalists would also grow to be more diverse. That's not what we're getting here. And a funny little side note, let's look at this last one. There you're seeing their job satisfaction rate, and you see it fairly steadily dipping from 1971 down to 2013. The number is half what it was last year as what it was in 1971. Now, perhaps part of that is the journalists sort of understanding that they're not filling the same role that they traditionally, historically did in America, or it could be tied in with the autonomy poll that we were talking about before, you know, that they don't feel like they can really pursue the stories that they think are important or newsworthy. Perhaps there's more centralized control from their newspaper or from their cable channel, something like that. I expect that would impact my job satisfaction. I mean, the stories that I'm covering today on the show, I chose them. Could have talked about anything. If I had my stories being handed to me, that would impact my satisfaction. Imagine how Wolf Blitzer feels about having to cover Flight 370 yet again. That takes a toll on your happiness at the job. But anyway, so this is just a little bit of sort of statistical, historical information about the state of journalism, both today and over the past 40 years. And I think that we should be worried about where journalism is going, because the government certainly isn't becoming more open or transparent about what it's doing. And with, you know, things like the NSA data mining and stuff like that, they have so much more access into our lives. We need access into what they're doing. And regular people like me and you, we can't do that day to day. We're too busy with our regular jobs, but we expect the press, we expect New York Times reporters, we expect CNN hosts to like send a couple of their producers, maybe a couple of their on-the-ground reporters, and find out what's actually going on. I honestly don't think that that's too much to ask. We give them a lot of power, a lot of influence in American society. It's time they start taking that seriously and start using it in service of the American people.